Hi guys, my name's Chris, welcome to my channel Weird Wacky Wonderful. Today I'm doing a video request, which is a motorcycle clutch and its components and how it works, which is part of a motorcycle transmission system. Now the transmission system takes power from the crank to the rear wheel. Obviously the clutch engages and disengages the power between the crank and the gearbox. So, if anybody wants to know, this book's called You and Your Bike by Brian Crichton. People have asked me in the past when I've used this book what the book's called and who it's made by. It's quite an old book, but it still does the job. So here we have a motorcycle clutch, and here, handy as it is, we have the components of the clutch. So as you can see there, the clutch drum, which is the big bit at the back. The friction plates, which are the orange coloured ones, which are the lighter ones. The all metal driven plates, as you can see there. And then the spring pressure plate with the springs and the bolts holding the springs. So, probably the most complicated part of this is understanding what spins and what doesn't. So when the clutch is fully engaged, as it is in there, everything is spinning. Everything is spinning in time and all locked together with this big arm here, and the springs will be fully extended, pressing the friction plates and into the driven plates. So everything is spinning. But then the hard part to understand is when this arm comes out by you pulling on the clutch lever and pulling against the force of the springs, what then happens? So the driven plates have little gears on the inside. My phone's not going to focus. Little gears on the inside which connect to the spring pressure plate, whereas the friction plates are engaged into the clutch drum all the time. Now the clutch drum, as you can see, is geared from the crank, so the clutch drum's going to spin all the time. So the friction plates are going to spin all the time. Whereas the driven plates are attached to the pressure plate. So when you pull the clutch lever in to disengage the clutch, the pressure plates and the driven plates are going to stop spinning. Then pressure plates and driven plates are going to the gearbox. So then when you release the clutch again, the driven plates are forced by these springs extending again, are forced into the friction plates and all compacted together into that gap there, all compacted together, and the force through friction is transferred into the gearbox. So as they're all packing together, the friction plates grab onto the driven plates, which is why you can get clutch slip if you run out of friction on your friction plates, because it'll just slide rather than grab. So as they pack together, it will start to turn again, this pressure plate and the driven plates, which are they go onto these teeth on the pressure plate, and then it will all begin to spin again. That's about all I can think of talking about on the clutch, really. I did this video at a request of somebody, so if I've covered what you wanted me to cover, please leave a like, and if I haven't covered what you wanted me to cover, then obviously leave a comment underneath telling me what you'd want to know about a motorcycle clutch. But I hope I've covered it for you, and thanks for watching, guys. See you later.